Hi friends, good day. Today I am taking up one more problem. First, let me start with profit or loss on sale of asset. Whenever any depreciable asset is sold during the year, depreciation is charged on it for the period it has been used during the year of sale also. The return on value after charging such depreciation is used for calculating the profit or loss on the sale of that asset. The resulting profit or loss on sale of asset is ultimately transferred to profit and loss account. It means that whenever asset is sold, up to the date of sale, you should calculate return on value. That should be compared with the sale price of the asset. You may get profit or loss. When book value is more than selling price is more than book value, profit. Suppose book value on the date of sale 100, selling price 120, gain. 120 minus 100, 20 rupees. Book value on the date of sale 100, selling price 80, you are getting a loss of 20. So that we will be knowing through this particular account. The machinery account of a factory showed a balance of rupees 2 lakhs on 1st January 2009. Its accounts were made up on 31st December each year and depreciation is written off at 10% per annum under diminishing balance method. The machinery account of factory showed a balance of 2 lakhs on 1st January 2009. Its accounts were made up on 31st December each year and depreciation is written off at 10% per annum. That means they are closing their books on 31st December and which method they are following? Diminishing balance. On 1st June 2009, a new machinery was acquired at a cost of 28,000 and installation charges incurred in erecting the machine works out to 2,000. So 28 plus 2000 coming to 30,000 on the same date. On 1st June 2009, a machine which had cost rupees 10,000 on 1st January 2007, that means the 10,000 rupees worth of machine is including 2 lakhs, was sold for 1300. Another machine which had cost 500 on 1st January 2008 was scrapped on the same date and it is realized nothing. Scrapped means can't be used. Write a plant and machinery account for the year 2009, ignore facts. So what I need to tell you clearly is, first I have to take you to working notes. See, please remember, a machinery may consisting of several machines. So, if you noticed here, on 1st June 2009, a machine which had cost 10,000 on 1st January 2007 was sold for 1300. It means you have to calculate return down value on 1st June 2009 from 10,000 rupees. It means this 10,000 rupees machine cost is reflecting in machinery account. I told you machinery account is consisting of several machines. We can't say machinery account number 1, machinery account number 2. It's not like that. All machines of a industry will be in the form of an account called as machinery account. It's a plural form. A machinery account is a plural form. It's not a singular form. A machinery account may consisting of more than one machine. In business, you will be using lot of machines, machinery, in manufacturing activities. So, this 2 lakhs written down value as on 1st January 2009. That means, showed a balance means they have been using the machinery for so long. As on that date, this balance is having a balance of 2 lakhs. It's not that you are purchased 2 lakhs rupees worth of machinery this year. It means opening balance. This 2 lakhs rupees including machinery that has been sold, machinery that has been scrapped. But actually, we need to have a balance of the missionary balance as on 1st January 2009. But here he has given 1st January 2009. So 1st January 2007 to 1st June 2009, because you use the missionary up to 2009, no? So for your calculation purpose, so what I need to do is that I have to explain you what is the written down value on the date of sale. When the mission has been sold, tell me, on 1st June 2009, a mission which had a cost of ₹10,000 on 1st January 2007 was sold off for ₹1,300. Clear to all of you? So let me take you to this now. Working notes number one. Profit or loss on sale of machine on 1st June 2009. How to calculate? Cost of machine. $10,000. Less. Depreciation up to 31st December 7. What is the percentage he has given? They are following 10% diminishing balance. Even on sold machinery also. It is coming to 1000. So this will become written down value on 118. Less depreciation. Up to 31st December 8. Diminishing balance method, no? That means whatever, it is also called a written down value. Whatever the balance which is there in the beginning, on that the depreciation will be calculated. If it is straight line, we always calculate on cost price of the asset. 9000 into 10%. It is coming to 8100. So I need to calculate when the machinery has been sold on 1st June 2009. No? And now to explain this, this is as on 1st January 2009 sold part of the machinery. Now this 2 lakhs rupees is include. This 2 lakhs rupees is including 8100. Clear to all of you? This 2 lakhs is including 8100. Why we went like this? Because we don't have the value as on this date, no? That is why we have started calculating the written down value in the beginning of the current year. But when this asset has been sold, it has been sold on 1st June 2009. Therefore, I am have to calculate depreciation up to 1st June 2009. Less depreciation up to the date of sale on 1st June 2009. That is for how many months I have to calculate? 5 months. So 8100 into 10% into 5 by 12, I have to calculate. 8100 into 10% into 5 by 12. You are getting 333.33. 337.5. It is coming to 338 rupees. You deduct it. 8100. I have rounded off to nearest rupee. Minus 338. It is coming to 7762. Is this clear? 7762. This is, I think you will be able to understand, WDV means return down value. Or it is also called as book value. On the date of sale. That means this book value is nothing but the value of the asset which is there as on the date of sale. This 338 rupees, 900 rupees, 1000 is consumed. That means this is the worth of asset that has been used. Nobody is going to pay 10,000 if you want to sell, because when you are using it, the value diminishes, no? So date return down value or book value in the date of sale, that is on 1-6-2009. Now this is to be, from this we shall deduct sale proceeds. Mention it has been sold for how much? 1300 rupees. 1300. So huge loss you are getting. See, 7762 rupee worth of asset has been sold for 1300. Minute, is it loss of how much? Come on, tell me. You are getting a loss of 6462. Loss on sale, commission is transferred to which account? Profit and loss account. It is already given the entries. P&L account at R2, asset account. Loss on sale of commission is transferred to P&L account. Similarly, I have to go for the next one account, next account also. Next asset also, rather. What is next asset? Another machine which had cost on 500 on 1st January was scrapped on the same date. And it realized nothing. Same date means here, on 1st Jan 2008, which had cost on same date means 1st June 2009. We are assuming same date means 1st June 2009. The asset which was purchased on 1st January 2008 was scrapped means within a period of how many months? 15 months, they felt that asset can't be used. It has realized nothing. So, whatever the return down value as on the date of asset is nothing but a loss. That we will be cross-checking here. Loss on machinery is kept. Scrapped means can't be used. What What is the meaning of scrapped? Can't be used. Cost of machine scrapped. Cost of machine scrapped. Or you can write cost of machinery. On 1st January 2008, 500. This value I need to have on 169. So I have to go for calculation of depreciation. Is coming to 450. This is book value or written down value on 119. Now I need to find out depreciation up to the date of scrapping. From how many months I have to calculate? 5 months. 4,500 into 10% into 5/12. 450 into 10% into 450 into 35 into 5/12. It is coming to 18.75. I am rounding it off to nearest rupee, 19 rupees. So 450 minus 19, 431. So this is the value of machinery as on the date, but nobody is going to buy that. Scrapped means it hasn't realized any value. So this entire amount is a loss. Now this amount 431, value of machinery. Scrapped is a loss. Transferred to P&L account. Clear to all of you? So we got two assets. One asset has been sold. Another asset has been scrapped. But I think you also got one asset has been purchased. On 1st June, a new machine was purchased at a cost. That means one asset has been sold. One asset has been scrapped on the same day, but another asset on the same day has been purchased. I think that is simple. No need to give any working notes to you. So just I am giving 2 minutes time. You quickly look at it. How I have calculated. Excuse me. How I have calculated the profit or loss on sale of machinery. Okay. So now I have to open which account? He is asking us to open, write a plant and machinery account for the year 2009. Ignore fractions. That is why we went for rounding of the rupee. So let me open machinery account now. Okay, so first what I should do here, you know the format, I am not giving importance to that. 1-1-2009, a machinery account is having a balance of, so previously we used to write bank because a machinery has been purchased. This is continuation, this is what is called as opening balance. Or opening book value. This is for you to understand. I am writing. No need to write in the examination. Or opening written down value. We'll be popularly using the term, using the abbreviation WDV. Means written down value. It is called as book value or opening balance. Clear to all of you? It is, we are having 2 lakh rupees. It has been mentioned 2 lakh rupees. Machinery account of factory showed a balance of 2 lakhs on 1st January 2009. Okay. Then also on 1st June 2009, a new machinery was acquired at a cost of 28,000 plus installation charges. It is coming to how much? 30,000. So this is new machinery. New machine purchased. New machine purchased. New machine is purchased for how much? 30,000 rupees. New machine is purchased for 30,000 rupees. So we also got the 2 machines have been sold. Okay, I have given you in the beginning of the class of this chapter, maybe first class or second class, I don't remember. I have told you the entries for sale. What is the entry for sale? Entry for sale, bank account data or to machinery. In machinery, you write buy bank. Let me write like this. Buy bank sale. It has been 1300 rupees has been received. And you have calculated depreciation up to the date of sale. Buy depreciation. Buy depreciation. Depreciation, we have to write 2 types of depreciation. One is depreciation on scrapped. This is 30th June, no? On 1-6. Because 1-1-2009, 450 is already including in 2 lakhs. So, since you are having your opened account for 2009 only, I need to have depreciation on sold part. Up for 1st June 2009, that is 338, and depreciation on scrapped part is how much? 19 rupees from 1st January 2009 to 1st June 2009. So buy bank sale, I am writing both together. by depreciation on sold machine, working notes number 1, 338, on scrapped one, working notes number 2, 19. So 338 plus 19, 357. Then next, you got a loss, no? By loss on sale, we got working notes number 1. And by loss on scrapped, this is loss on scrap 431. Loss on sale 6462. So these two will be transferred to which account? Machinery account. $6,462, $431. That's it. This is about sale. Now, on 31st December 2009, I have to calculate depreciation on remaining asset. On remaining asset. And then on new asset. So by depreciation, on remaining old asset, on remaining old asset, depreciation on remaining old asset. So how to find out, sir? This 2 lakhs is there, no? 2 lakhs. This is sale proceeds, depreciation, loss. If you deduct all these values, you will be getting the book value. Very simple. Sir, how, sir? Take 2 lakhs. Minus amount received, how much? 1300. Minus depreciation, 357. Minus loss 6462. Minus loss on scrapped 431. Why you are deducting, sir? Because you got the money for sale. You also got the loss. Okay, these things if you deduct, you'll be getting book value of the asset as on the date of closing the books of accounts. 2 lakhs is the beginning of the year. 1300 has been sold, so that machinery has gone. So suppose 100 rupees asset, 200 rupees asset, 100 rupees asset has been sold. How they will be having? 20 rupees collected, 30 rupees depreciation, 50 rupees loss, like that. This is sale proceeds. This is depreciation. This is loss. This is loss on scrap. So come on, take the calculator. 2 lakhs minus 1300 minus 357 minus 6462 minus 431. You are getting Just a minute. Yeah. 191,450 into 10%. This is the book value of the remaining asset. Book value of the remaining asset. 191,450 into 10 by 100. Or this amount also you can calculate like this. Simple words. What is book value on 119 on the after machine has been sold, scrapped. 450 minus 19, 431 here, 7,762. Is written down value, book value 7,762. Here it is 431. If you deduct this, you'll be getting same thing. Okay, that I don't go into the, leave it. So 2 lakhs minus 1300 that has been received, 357 is loss, 6,462 rupees is the loss on sale of asset, 431 is loss on sale of asset, you are getting 191,450. This is the written down value of the remaining asset. On the 10%, if you calculate, you will be getting 19,145. Please try to understand. I need to calculate depreciation remaining asset. This is old asset. Out of old asset, this is sale proceeds received. This is depreciation after the date of sale. This is loss on sale. Then what happened? This is the value of remaining asset. On that, you have calculated 19,145. Then you also need to calculate depreciation on new machinery purchase. When it has been purchased? 1/6. Therefore, for how many months you have to calculate? 7 months. New machine. From the date of purchase, to date of sale. What is the date of purchase here? 1st June. What is the date of closing? 31st December 9. 30,000. Not up to the date of closing, sorry. So 30,000 into 10 by 100 into, for how many months I have to calculate? 7 by 12. That is 1st June 9 to 31st December 9. You can count June, July, August, September, October, November, December. How many months you are getting? 7 months. 30,000 into 10% into 7 by 12. 1750. Now you can find out the closing balance. What is the total? 2,30,000. So you can cross check 2,30,000 minus 1300 minus 357 minus 6462. You'll be getting, you can cross check 2 lakhs. This is your answer. You can cross check any calculation mistakes are there. 2,555 is the answer. Clear to all of you? This is how you have to prepare machinery account. Simple words, out of 2 lakhs, this is the value of assets sold. The 2 lakhs sold, depreciation loss. Suppose 100 rupees has been sold. This is 20 collected, 30 depreciation, 50 loss, like that. Then 200 rupees minus 100. On 100, you have to calculate depreciation. The same logic. On the remaining asset, old minus sold part, you will be getting remaining one. Remaining one, you have to calculate at the rate of 10% for full year. The new machine, since has been purchased on 1st June 2009, you calculate depreciation for how many months? Only for 7 months you are calculating. Okay. So, with this, I am concluding this class also. So, then we can see one more class. With one more class, I shall be able to finish off the 1 hour, 1.5 hour class I will be taking. The total depreciation chapter will be completed. After that, I will be going for inventory valuation. Okay. So we will meet in the next class. Till then, goodbye. Thank you. God bless you all.